very important. And unfortunately, we all get compromised because of time limits, because of XYZ reasons, because of our own lack of sincerity or attitude, that we lack that kind of process. We always try to shorten that concept. Kal teacher ko dikhana hai, do din mein design bana hai, aage put up kar diya. Teen din mein presentation hai. Design is a process. You should get yourself so involved in that design that that 2 months of design process should shorten in your mind in 24 hours or 48 hours to get the best of results as per time efficiency. Second, when we move ahead, your concept has to get converted into schematics, right? Schematics mein, we always are so much restricted. Front elevation, backside elevation. I'm talking to students, I think, professionals, all we have all gone to that stage. Left side elevation, right side elevation, rear elevation. I don't know. Elevation is elevation. Why is front and so everything is a front elevation. Wherever person is going to see is going to be the elevation which is prominent enough. Why do we restrict ourselves in our mind? Your creation is going to be sculpture. Sculpture is characterized by a particular feature that it looks good from all the sides. You see squares which are constructed, which worldwide all squares look good from all the sides. It doesn't have a back elevation and a front elevation. Get these concepts out of your mind. Your creations have to be sculptural. They have to be iconic. So there are no elevations. It's a unit by itself. Planning has to merge itself out into facades, has to merge out into a good standing form. Then come services. Imagine human body, a very perfect example. Today there is some problem with the kidney or the liver. What happens? Body, how much beautiful it is, it goes for a toss. Similarly, smallest of details of MEP structures or air conditioning, plumbing, electrical, even the switch doesn't work, you start become so judgmental about architect ne kya design kiya hoga, isne kya design kiya hoga. How many of us we have actually going to that particular detail to even analyze whatever your consultants are giving it to you? And to analyze those particular things, you need to yourself expose to those particular things that you should know first of all what they're giving it to you. Going in depth, unfortunately, I've seen in Indian schools, I don't think many people compromise on these kind of things. They just feel making architectural design is more than enough. It's not enough. You have to promise the world what God has promised you, a perfect world, a perfect building, a perfect environment. Then you have to fit in your landscapes, you have to fit your interiors, you have to fit those particular things. So which of the part is not necessary? Everything is necessary. Like Vivek said, you have a specialized like landscape architect, interiors. So I get many people say, I am not interested in interiors, I'm an architect. I want to do it. Initially for first 3 years of students who ever pass out, they give me this kind of answers. How can you say that interior is not a part of your life? I mean, you would like to stay in a good house, you would like to stay in a good hotel. Making a good building is equally an important responsibility as doing a good interiors. To get to the good interiors, it is equally important to have a perfect services. So there's a new concept which is going on, which is called as buildings are not appreciated now by the good facades. It's appreciated by the performances now. So you have to give your client, you have to give your society a perfect building a building which performs 100% well with the whole thing. So I think my time is 5 minutes. So my summary to a small time, whatever is given, do not take your responsibility lightly. Consider yourself actually as demigods and analyze and judge yourself about your inputs which you give to each and every challenge you touch and you sort of perform. Put your heart in the design. Your passion should flow with your thought process. It will definitely give you best results. The case studies itself are very, very interesting. I'm very impressed by the students, especially I think Mansi and Michelle. With the kind of inputs and thought processes what they've given, and it becomes so interesting that we are all going to be architects one day and we are actually going to do these things like. Let the interaction be there. Before I end, I'll just give you an example. I was invited to NYU 3 years back for a lecture which was for 45 minutes. They squeezed my balls out for 3 hours, and by the time I moved out of that particular conference of mine, nothing more to offer them. The students were so interactive. Unfortunately, principals are here. I must tell you that your students do not ask questions. It's your right to ask questions for any professionals who are standing on this particular dais and get anything which is clarified, because you have invested your time in sitting here. Do not disrespect your time by not asking questions and be insensitive about whatever is happening on the board. So with this, all the best to you and God bless you.
Thank you.